1 year ago, 58 people were killed, hundreds injured after a man opened fire at a music festival in Las Vegas. Since then, some lawmakers have been working to ban a device used by the shooter.
That device is called a bump stock, and it turns a semi-automatic weapon into an automatic weapon. News for Utah's Karen Murphy tells us a year later, the progress is slowly moving forward.
Before the deadly Las Vegas massacre, bump stocks were a relatively unknown device, but have since become a focal point in the gun control debate.
Bump stock is an apparatus that replaces a stock assembly that simply allows the shooter to pull the trigger faster.
After the shooting, both Democratic and Republican lawmakers pushed for a ban on the devices. The first sign of change came in February when the Trump administration ordered the Justice Department to issue regulations banning bump stocks. But the change is slow.
They're hoping to do something very quickly at the federal level, although I have read that there will be a number of groups that are going to litigate this issue and file suits immediately.
Several states already passed their own regulations banning them. Utah is not one of them, but lawmakers are drafting legislation for the upcoming session.
And they can kill so many people. You look at what happened in Las Vegas. 1,100 rounds went off and killed so many people and injured hundreds and hundreds more. And that happened in just a few minutes.
And today, another step forward on the federal level. President Trump saying in a press conference, a ban is coming soon.
So we're knocking out bump stocks. I've told the NRA, I've told them, bump stocks are gone.
I'm Karen Murphy reporting news for Utah.
President Trump added during that press conference, the bump stock ban would be coming in the next couple of weeks.